Yes, children. So today I think we have stopped with the formula for simple interest. Formula for finding simple interest, isn't it? What do you mean by simple interest, or what is the formula for simple interest, Parvati?
Principal into rate into time by 100.
Principal into rate into time by 100. PRP by 100. And we have done one problem related to it, and I have given a homework also based on that, isn't it? Two problems we have done. Can you tell me what is the answer for that homework?
8,625.
8,625. Sangeeta, ma'am.
Is it calling?
Ma'am, I was absent last day.
Okay, that is simple. You have to, when we do the problem, you will understand. One problem we'll do. Homework, I will do it. Okay. Because principal is the amount which we borrow, and for number of years, that is time period. T is time period for which we borrow the money, and R is the rate of interest when we take loan from bank for 3 years. We are taking loan from bank. They will not agree if you give back the same money, no? After 3 years, you will have to pay the interest for it. Some extra money you have to pay as interest. Okay, this is about that. So principal means the amount which we borrow. And interest, R is the rate of interest. And T is the time period. Time period for which we borrow the amount. PRT by 100 will give you the interest. Simple interest. So when we do the problem, you will understand. The homework I'll explain. After that, I'll give you another type of problem for that. What happened? Something easy.
Ma'am, today are we doing the worksheet?
Wait. If there is time, we can do it. EC board I'll take. EC board is not taken. That's what. But it was there. Okay, children, there is no need of. Did I share?
No, ma'am.
Can you see the board?
No, ma'am.
No. Something happened for the board. Children, can you leave and enter once more?
Okay, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am.
It's not working.
Yes, ma'am.
I don't know what happened.
Bye.
Ta-da.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Leave. I'm just ending. I cannot end also. I cannot end the meeting. Oh, let me switch off this. Okay. I think now it is okay. Let me see. Some are entering now. Yes. Check once more.
Homework.
Yes. Yeah, homework. Can you see now board?
Yes, ma'am.
You can see the board.
Yes,
okay.
Ma'am.
Okay. So I have shared already. That's what. So now we will
I'm
see.
Parvati and Amna is asking you to let them.
It's not there. Okay. Yeah. Now I can see. This was the homework, I think. Profit and loss. Open. 50%, okay. See, this homework was this one. Find the amount to be paid at the end of 3 years. This one we have done. This one was the homework. principal is 7,500, isn't it? Principal amount was 7,500. Zoom out.
And principal amount means?
That is the money which we borrow from the bank. Suppose we are borrowing from the bank, okay? 7,500.
You told to find the P, right?
P? Yeah. Wait.
8,625.
Okay, 1 minute. It is principal is given. How much? 7,500 rupees. Now, rate of interest is given 5%. And for how many years it is given? T. It is for 3 years. 3 years. Now, what is the formula for simple interest? Simple interest is equal to PRT by 100. So, simply substitute there. P is what? 7,500.
Is that formula? PRT by
100. Yes, formula. R is equal to 5 into time period is 3 divided by 100. Okay, so what will you get? 75 into 5 into 3. What did you get as answer? It is 1,125. Multiply, you will get 5 into 3, 15. 15 into 75, you will get 1,125.
It's the last class only this you took, right?
Yes. Yes. Yeah. So simple interest is
the amount is equal to.
Amount is equal to
principal plus interest. Yes.
Amount is equal to 7,500 plus 1,125. Okay. Just borrowing the money. Okay. If you take some money, borrow some money from bank and give the same money back after 3 years, they will not agree, isn't it? We have to pay some interest. Why did you deposit in the bank? Bank
not
deposit.
To be stolen.
To get something out of it, isn't it? To get interest out of it. So that is known as interest. Did you understand, Hessa? Just see the video of previous class.
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, that didn't come, that class.
That will come today.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay. That will be coming or in the YouTube, you can see.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay. Now, next question, you just see, all of you. You'll be having written exams, okay? Annual exam.
Ma'am, we are going to school and writing, right?
No. You'll be sitting at home and writing. But written exam will be there. Okay, can you try the next question? Here, it is a different question. We have to find the simple interest is already given there. See, SI, simple interest is given. SI is equal to 280. And see what rate gives 280 as interest on a sum of rupees 56,000. So principal also we know it is 56,000. Principal amount is 56,000. In how many years? 2 years. So T, time period is 2 years. So what all things are given? Simple interest is given. Principal is given.
Time
period is given. And we have to find out what.
280 divided by 100.
280
what
divided
is that?
By?
Ninth question. 1,212% PA.
Per annum. Per annum. Per annum means per year. 12% per year. That is the meaning. Okay. Per year means each year. So, 2 years. So, what we have to find out here? What rate? We want to find the rate. R is not given. So, we have to find out the rate. Just apply the formula. We will get it. Okay. Just apply the formula. We can apply the formula. What is simple interest? Simple interest is equal to PRT
by
100. Now we can write simple interest is given 280 is equal to P is also given 56,000 into R we don't know, so write it there R itself into T time period 2 by 100. Okay, now you know when we want to find the value of an unknown.
Ma'am, 1/4.
1/4, very good. So we have to bring the other
0.25%.
Other things along with that. It's relatives to the other side. It's transpose, isn't it? Other variables to the other side. So what we will do? We will transpose. Make R alone. I told you in algebra we do that. Make R alone. So what R on this side? Bring all to the left side. So 280 into 100 will come on top, isn't it? Reciprocal. When you take it to the other side, it will become reciprocal. So 56,000. Then what is there? Into 2 is equal to R. Did you understand this step? I have shifted all the numbers to the left side, making R alone. Okay, transposed. So numerator will become denominator, denominator will become numerator. Now you cancel 100, 100 cancelled, 10, 10, 0, 0 cancelled. Now what is remaining? 28 and 56. You know 28 into 2 is 56. So 28, ones are 28, 28 into 2, 56. So what is remaining? 1/2 into 2. That is, we get R is equal to 1/4, isn't it? 1/4,
yes.
Means it is,
yes.
0.25%.
Ma'am, PRT means what?
That is the formula for calculating simple interest. Principal into rate of interest into time period, that is T, by 100. That is the formula for calculating simple interest. From that, for finding principal also, you can do like this. Next problem is finding principal. Did you understand this problem, children? If R is given, how to find?
Ma'am.
If all other elements are given, how to find one? That you have to understand. If rate of interest is given, principal is given, how to, and interest is given, how to find number of years? Same procedure. Okay. Now, next problem you read.
Wait, ma'am, don't rub.
No, not rubbing.
Ma'am, principal means the money which we borrow. And simple,
yes.
Interest means?
Means the
when
money.
We give it back.
When you give back, you cannot give back the same amount. Some additional amount you have to give along with that. Isn't it?
Ma'am,
question, which is the simple interest?
Which one? Which question?
280 is the simple interest. 280.
Interest is given. See, 280 as interest.
Ma'am, so 280 is lower than the money which we borrowed, right?
Oh, yes, of course, because that is the additional money given to create an interest in the person who is giving you, isn't it? Suppose, Hessa, you have borrowed 25,000 rupees from Lakshmi. Lakshmi became rich one day, so she is giving you 25,000 rupees. You need something you want, so you are borrowing 25,000 rupees from her for 2 years. After 2 years, if you return back the same money, she will not allow, isn't it? She should be given something in favor or in addition to that. At least one fish fry, right? She'll be happy. That is called
interest. Principal is equal to 500.
Yes, yes, correct. Answer is correct. Okay, so she'll be happy. Lakshmi, do you eat fish? No.
Every food she will eat, ma'am.
Okay, okay. So,
Ma'am, now I stopped.
So she stopped it. So you can give something else, peda or jalebi or something sweet, isn't it? We cannot give that.
Ma'am, after borrowing, we should give more money
than what we borrowed.
Here we are finding how much we have to give more.
How much we are giving more? That is called simple interest. That is the formula is principal into number of years into rate of interest by 100. That is the formula. Understood? How much we have to give back? That we are calculating. That is called simple interest. The money which we give in addition, that is known as simple interest. See, in post office and all, if you deposit, you will get something interest, 6% interest, 7% interest for recurring deposit, time deposit. You have not heard that, anything else like that? Anything like that?
Post office, I have.
Post office, you have. Deposit, students also have.
Yes, deposit we have.
So for the deposit, simply you won't go and deposit in bank, no? After some 1 year or 2 year, you should get additional increase money, isn't it?
So last problem we done 56,000 into 280 into 2, right? By 100.
Yeah.
So why here we didn't add? Yeah, ma'am, like you wrote, right? Simple interest is equal to PRT by 100. Inside you wrote 280 is equal to 56,000.
That is simple interest is 280 here. It is given.
Repeat. Can I repeat it?
This one.
Yes, ma'am. 10th question.
That is. See here. In this question, it is given. Rate of interest is not given. We want to find out what rate gives. See, in the first problem, the principal amount which we borrow is given, interest rate is given, number of years, that is T is given, PRT is given. We want to find out simple interest. That was the question. So directly you apply in this formula, you will get the answer. Okay, but in the second question, This is given, but rate is not given. This is not given. We want to find out that. Okay, so what we do, first we write what is given, what all things are given. Write the formula. Simple interest equals principal into rate of interest into T, number of years. We wrote it. From that, we will make rate a loan and bring everything to the left side and find out the value of R. Here we use the rule of algebra. Understood when?
Yes, ma'am.
That's all. It is very simple. Now, I'll give you homework. Okay. Then it will be more easy. When you do so many problems, it will be clear to you. Now you listen next problem, you see. When I do the next problem again, it will be more clear.
Ma'am, next problem is 500.
Yes.
Principal.
Yes, yes.
Ma'am, first we have to find the interest, right?
Interest, if it is given, no need to find. You have to write it there. That's all. Interest, sometimes interest will be given. You have to find the rate of interest. Sometimes the principal and the rate of interest will be given. Interest also will be given. You have to find a time period. So accordingly, you have to change. See the next question. If Meena gives an interest of, so interest is there given already. Okay. So Meena gives an interest of rupees 45 for 1 year at 9% rate per annum. Per annum per year. What is the sum she borrowed? So here what we want to find out? P. We want to find out P, isn't it? Remaining everything is given. So we write the formula, simple interest is equal to PRT by 100. Now what is given in this question? Interest rate is given, simple interest is given, rupees 45, that is equal to P, principal, we don't know, it is not given, we want to find out, into what R, rate of interest, 9% it is given, 9, into time period, how many years?
1.
1 year,
one.
It is given 1 year, 1. By 100. This is your formula. Okay. Now we have inserted everything inside the formula. Now what we want to do? We have to find out the unknown in this. What is unknown? What we want to find out?
P.
P.
Principal.
Principal we want to find out. So what you have to do? Make it alone. Bring everything else to the other side. Understood this much?
Yes.
Okay. So we are going to bring this to the left side. So 45, denominator will become numerator, numerator will become denominator, into 100 by 9 into 1. Did you understand this step? We made P alone
and
there.
So why we took that 1, 2 down and 9 also down?
When you transpose, I have told you numerator will become denominator, will become numerator. That is the rule of transposing. Negative will become positive, positive will become negative. When you change the side or transpose.
Ma'am, principal is equal to 500.
Yeah, with the 9 you can cancel 45. 9, 5s are 45. 5 into 100, 500. So we'll get P is equal to 500 rupees. Understood?
Yes, ma'am.
In the previous problem, it was you have to find what rate is given. Rate. Interest on a sum, you want to find the rate of interest.
Rate of interest.
Instead of P, it was R. That's all. Okay. In the place of P, it was R. Is it clear, children?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So this chapter is over. I'll give you homework based on this. That is when when principal, number of years and rate of interest is given, you will have to find SI, simple interest. When simple interest is given, you have to find the rate of interest, like that, some problems. Okay, then you will be clear, it will be clear to you. Same rule you can apply and find out the answer. Now we'll pass on to the next chapter. We don't have time to rest. We have to complete.
Ma'am, how many chapters are there left?
This only actually for exam. We are taking only this chapter, more constructions. The other two I'll give as usually I used to be given as project. Okay, you have to read and present it. But this time,
what is the next chapter?
Next chapter we are going to take constructions. Constructions. You have your pen.
Next chapter.
Ma'am, geometry.
Geometry. You have your geometry box with you?
No, ma'am.
You have?
Yes, ma'am.
The cupboard.
Or else you have to go and find out. Children?
No, how many cupboard. It's there.
It's there. Just take it
now. Oh, it is now.
If you take, don't take more time. Oh. Take it. Okay. 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 Or else you listen. Afterwards, you can draw. If you draw with me, it is good. Take your compass and ruler and come. Those who have. If you have thrown out somewhere, don't go in search of that. Okay. If you have it with you, take it. Next class, you have to bring. Okay. Next class, you bring instrument box with you. Compass.
Yes, ma'am, I got.
Ruler and pencil. Take it out. So in the previous chapter, you have studied about percentages, profit and loss, and simple interest. Okay, these are the important topics. Ratios. So the next chapter we are going to start is the...
I'm comparing quantities only.
Comparing quantities over. I have... not for you. I'll send the notes. Okay. Comparing quantities over.
Rational numbers, only that much notes, right?
Ah, yes. Only that much is needed. You do the last exercise. Same as fractions. Okay. Same as fractions. And you will get some chapters from first term also for this exam. Annual exam. Annual exam. I'll give you the portions. Portions for exam. Important chapters which have continuation in the next year will be given more importance. So, that chapters I'll give you. You can prepare yourself nicely. Written exam will be there. Plus one word also.
Ma'am, MCQ also will be there?
MCQ also will be there. MCQ plus this exam.
Okay, ma'am.
Written exam also. So we have to do a thorough revision for that written exams. So let us start with the new chapter. Well, we will start now. Otherwise, we will not continue. Okay, we will not start. We'll be sticking to the previous chapter only. So let me start now. Just understand how to do. If you don't have the compass or ruler, no problem. After understanding, you do it. Okay, in the next class, we can start with the constructions of triangle. Just listen how to do it. In this chapter, actually, heading of the chapter, you can write that chapter 1, chapter 10. Chapter 10, practical geometry. Chapter 10, practical geometry. Then practical geometry. Chapter 10, practical geometry. In this chapter, what you learn is about some constructions. First one is construction of parallel lines. How to construct parallel lines. A line parallel to another line given. Then you have four constructions. First one is SSS construction, SAS construction, ASA construction, and RHS construction. That is criteria for construction. That is, you have studied that as criteria for congruence, isn't it? Congruence criteria. I'm not specifying that name, you will get confused. So we'll see how to construct a triangle when all the three sides are given. How to construct a triangle when two sides and the included angle is given. How to construct a triangle when two angles and included side is given. Then how to construct a 90 degree angled triangle. These are the four constructions which you have to study in this chapter. First construction is about a construction of parallel lines. So you know what is parallel line?
Which keeps a specific distance between them.
These two, suppose I am saying these two are parallel lines, line L and line M are parallel. If I say like that, I mean that it keeps a particular distance, perpendicular distance between these two lines are same or equal. Perpendicular distance between the two lines remain the same. Okay. Okay. Now, what is going on? Is this... Okay. This is the meaning of parallel lines. Now, what we are going to do is we are going to draw a line parallel to a line already given to you.
Ma'am, I just joined now. Ma'am, what did you take?
I'm going to finish, my dear.
Ma'am, what did you take?
I'm going to start now. Now that remaining two problems of the chapter, previous chapter, finished, remaining two problems. Chapter. PNR by 100, PTR, PRT by 100, that's SI, simple interest formula. After that, constructions we are going to start. That's all. So just see, I'm going to draw a line parallel to another line. So what first we will draw a line. So for that, take your scale. Take your scale. Ruler. You're taking the ruler. This is the zero. Start from zero. I'm drawing 8 cm. I have drawn 8 cm line. After that, I'll mark it. The line I will mark. Here I'll take a point B here. B. I'm taking, after that you take a point A outside the line. Take a point A outside the line.
And we should draw like this?
Yes, 1 minute. Something is today no remedial class. What is going on? It is, some are laughing. I don't know what is it. Okay, just listen to the class. Okay, look here, I have drawn a line. I have put a point B there. I have put a point A on top. Now what I'm going to do is, I'm going to draw a line parallel to the line which I have drawn. This is line L, let it be the line L. For that, after this, I will be joining. I will be joining the line. Keep the scale over here. Now, join it with A. asking this.
From B to A?
Yes, from B to A, just draw a line. It is easy for you, but it is...
We can put point anywhere.
Ah, yes, anywhere, anywhere. Just put a point there, anywhere. To move the scale, I need time. Yeah. You can draw a line joining through the point. Okay? Just join the line. Okay? So, I have drawn a line joining A and B. Now, you have to take the compass. Take the compass. Take the compass. Now, you have to take the compass and keep it here. Any radius you can take. Any radius you can take. Take the compass, fix the pencil. Any radius you can take, and you have to draw a cut an arc. Just cut an arc. You have cut the arc. Then with the same radius. This much is clear?
Yes, ma'am.
With the same radius, you go there up to A. Keep the needle point at A. And just with the same radius, you draw another arc. You have drawn another arc. After that, what you have to do is you have to measure the arc length. That is, the measure the arc length from here to here. Okay. You keep the compass needle here. Just extend it. Pencil tip you keep here. So you will get the arc length. Do it like that. Just place the needle point here on the baseline. At that point, I'll show you the point where you have to keep. It is here. Okay. Can you see the point? Needle point here, pencil point here. You will get the arc length. Then keep the compass, and you can mark here the point. Here it is G. Okay, point, that point you mark as G there. Compass, keep it here. The radius is with you. Okay, not with me, the radius is with you. You just draw the arc to cut it. Here. Children, did you understand? With that radius, just cut an arc. Keep the point here as H.
Ma'am, everything same measure we should take, right?
No. I told here, this one. Last step is little different. You have to measure the arc length and then keep it at G and cut the arc. Otherwise, all radius same. You can mark, make a mark here, C and B, C, D here. So you have to take the arc length of DC, then cut the arc. You will, then after that, what you have to do is remove the compass. Okay, then take the scale. Take the scale. Place it. Okay, place it like this. Just draw a line joining that. So you will be getting parallel line. Will be getting a line which is parallel to the baseline. Is it clear? No. Let me take attendance this time. Sriram?
Present, ma'am.
Aditya Anoop?
Present, ma'am.
Anand Abhinand Krishna?
Present, ma'am.
Abhinav Bijoy?
Present, ma'am.
Abhinav PA?
Abhinav Absent.
PA? Absent. Ahmed Afin? Albert Dojo?
Absent.
Amal Anthony?
Present.
Present, ma'am.
Yes, Amna Sharin.
Present.
Anand Haji.
Present.
Angelia.
Present.
Anthony Babu.
Present.
Anusha Ratish. Anusha.
Anusha.
Anusha Ratish.
Anusha, absent.
Absent. Arjun MR.
Present.
Present, ma'am.
Ayan.
Present.
Benedict?
Absent.
Carlin?
Present.
Dilla Darshan?
Present.
Okay.